Right, here we are. Back at it with Castlevania Symphony of the Night. Previously we have explored most of what appears to be most of the castle, gotten what seems to be the bad ending by confronting or Richter in Dracula's chamber, and now we're searching for a way to get a better ending. Field rod. So what I didn't know the last time was the gold ring enough is not sufficient to gain entry to the area we want to go. We also need the silver ring. Where's the silver ring? Hard to say, but thing I will say, I want to get the heart upgrade here before we head out. I picked it up there previously, but you don't retain anything after the save when you go to fight the boss. So I consulted the internet for a clue to discover why the gold ring wouldn't work, and I found, well, you need the silver ring also. I assumed I had the silver ring already, but that does not appear to be the case. Decide whether I ought to pick it up again, or just try to search the castle. There's very few places left unexplored. That's just the watery areas. We're gonna try that. Do I have a library card? I do have library cards. So I think we're gonna go to the bottom of the castle. Just try to get to the stuff that's in the water. See if there's anything down there. And go to the library. I did not mean to hit up again. May as well check the library since we're here now. Oh well. Thank you. Forgot about that. Now I remember. That looks right, maybe.
Young Master Alucard, how may I
show? How about this? How about this?
It is not here. Top of the castle again. Just below the top of the castle. Front of the castle. This should be the one I want. Yep. Bottom of the castle. Man, so goes my axe. You look at this, doesn't that look extremely suspicious? Do anything with that, but we will press on. I probably should have bought a couple more potions. Blue water, you say? Nope. Down here somewhere. Wait, I didn't go here? Oh, that's a save point. How did I never go here? No matter, I've gone now. And not really missing anything because this is a solid wall. I just saved, so we can risk a little bit of mortal peril messing around with the water. That's the gravity boots. I had to look that up. It doesn't give you instructions for them. Can I get out of the water this way? Can. Good to know. Holy water is great for the fish. Heads. Okay, a life upgrade. For sure worth getting. It was not the silver ring. Gonna die. I'd love to get out of the water and save this health upgrade. We go right, there's a save point. Probably not possible to ever move this crate again, is it? There's something down there, giving me a sure sign that I can somehow reach it, although suggesting it's not the ring I'm looking for. If we clear every gray spot on the map and haven't found it, I am gonna look it up. So getting hit by the enemy negates the damage from the water briefly. Unchaku. There needs to definitively be nothing down here. Okay. Forgot about that. Very used potion on me. Alright, so we're back to the save point. And then we'll see if there's any chance we can check out the wet side of the vertical waterfall room. A shoe or something. Probably gonna lose my batness as soon as I fly in the water. It stuns me. And I can't pass it. Some shoes over there, but that appears to be it. I did not need to fly up with a bat. Where is this? But, does it do anything? It does not really. Okay, I'm looking carefully at the map. You, dear viewer, are no doubt spotting where I need to go right away. Okay, the only areas on the map that are grayed out that I can see are the under this waterfall, as we just noticed, Dracula's chamber at the top of the castle, and in the top left quadrant, that long horizontal corridor, which is lined with spikes that we could fly between with the bat, but then there's a blue door we can't open without resuming our human form, which results in us getting annihilated by spikes. I don't see any other doors to unexplored areas anywhere on the map. Maybe we can try for an indirect clue, because we have the merman statue. We have no idea what that does. Summons the oarsman. That's not really specific. summons the oarsman to appear at two locations where he doesn't normally appear. Oh, okay. That's a clue. I don't know if it will help us. So apparently, if we go to the right from here and then down at the save point, we can meet the oarsman again. So we went down here some time ago and fought a boss.
This wall.
Something about this wall. That is good to know, Fairy, but it doesn't seem like there's anything I can do with it this time. Interesting. Ankle deep is not enough to do any damage. Was a bust.
About this wall.
Hello, it's the floor, not the wall. Okay, so there he is. If I turn off the merman statue, he's not there. But the post where he ties up is clearly visible, so that would be the clue.
Thy destiny awaits, O Prince.
All right. There's something. Oops. Oh boy. An onyx. I missed my boat. I guess the mermaid statue is kind of superfluous once you got the bat. quite a lot to this. Thanks, dude. Holy symbol. Protection while underwater. The holy symbol kind of looks like a snorkel. And we don't take damage now. In the water. So we cleared out that portion of the unexplored map. Okay, so we cleared that area and did not gain the silver ring. Right. So now let's try the waterfall again. That's one important finding, is that going in the water as the wolf with the holy symbol does not force a transformation. Here already and got something. I don't remember what it was. Secret boots. Pray tell, do secret boots do? And what kind of an item are they? Discreetly increases height. Is there any use for that? I think it made him maybe one pixel taller. I'm not sure. Okay. We are once again stumped. Okay. I have gained the knowledge needed. Some of it. To head for that spiked corridor. All right. We're good. So we do want to go to the spiked hall. But it seems that I have what's needed to pass it. I just didn't know. I don't even know that we want to use a teleporter. We just want to make our way up through the laboratory and the chapel. In which case, we should just take this. Whoa. Thank you. This elevator is so useless.
Something about this wall.
We're not talking about the floor, are we? What a time to have traded in the holy water. Okay, thank you, fairy. Safe to say I was not gonna come up with this on my own. We'll hit the save point real quick. Yeah, that's not promising. Who I was consulting suggested the Echo of Bat is needed skill. It is not used to just straight up open the door. That we'll have to. Useful for. I guess I could have gone wolf. Definitely want to save before I mess around with the Please just die. The bat can move a little faster. Well, I guess it isn't really necessary because you can move quickly horizontally with the wolf and vertically with this. So we want to go up from here. Go up from here. Huh. I'm getting a little bit over sales with that. Although it is going to be an exceptionally good way to climb the tower here. Oops. Well, almost. Right, here we go. Right, mist could pass. Oh, back. This is just a spot to let you recover if you mess up like I just did. You gotta be joshing me. No, please don't. There's no need for that. What item was that? I need more help. Okay. I did not put it together. The Echo of Bat was needed to gain the Spike Breaker, which I had all along. I'm not used to just your regular old armor being a progression item. Seems like I should have figured it out, though. Maria!
Alucard, have you seen Richter?
There is a Belmont here. You are right about that.
I knew it. Where is he?
The one I saw was with the enemy. He called himself the Lord of this castle.
What? That's impossible. You're wrong. I have to go.
And there it is. Okay. I'm sure I had seen that before I ever picked up the Spike Breaker armor. Don't really have an excuse for not figuring that out. That is the dead end. It's like we either want to go up or go left and down. Oh. You essentially want to go straight across. This is a save point, isn't it? Yeah.